Welcome back to Natural Living with Zenana. I am here to bring you a quick and honest review of Jane Iredale's Lip Drink SPF Lip Balm. A few of you have been asking me about SPF lip care and about tinted lip balm. I came across these Jane Iredale Lip Drink Lip Balms, and I thought I would give them a try for you. This is an honest review. I wanted to let you know that I do buy all of my products to review them for you. This is not sponsored. It is just my experience with these lip balms. So listen to the whole video. You'll get my honest opinion about this product and all the information you need to know to determine whether it's a good product for you to use or not. So let's get right into it. You know that the three things that I like to look at when I'm reviewing a product are, number one, ingredients. Are they safe? Are they clean? Are they effective? Number two, we look at performance. Does the product do what it says it will do? And number three is sustainability. What about the packaging? What's the packaging like? Is it recyclable? Is it biodegradable? Is it refillable? So that is important to me. Sustainability is very important to me. I'm sure if you are here, that's important to you as well. So that's another thing that we look at when we're checking out a product. So let's get right into it with Jane Iredale Lip Drink Lip Balm. I have three of them here. I purchased sheer, and then I purchased two others that are in two shades, Buff and Flirt. And I'm wearing Flirt right now, so you can see what that looks like throughout this video. And I will also put a little inset up here of me wearing Buff so that you can see what Buff looks like. Buff has actually been my favorite shade out of the two that I purchased. Flirt is lovely too. It's a little brighter pink. It's pretty, but Buff has a little bit more of a natural and neutral shade. Both are great. It just depends on whether you want something more vibrant or not. And then there is always sheer. Sheer is great when you don't want any color at all. So let's talk about ingredients. So I did go to Think Dirty and I looked up this product, the Lip Drink Lip Balm from Jane Iredale. And Think Dirty gives it a score of 3, which is a great rating. So it is a very good, clean product. On EWG, I looked up all of the ingredients. It is vegetable oil based and carnauba wax. And then it has aloe vera. It has a bunch of green tea extract, berry extracts, lemon peel oil. So it's a lot of really nourishing, clean ingredients. So the only thing that I found with this product that is of concern is that at the bottom it says may contain, and then it has a list of several things. One is mica, the next thing is iron oxides, which those are both fine, by the way, no problem with either of those. But then it lists a couple of red shades, and that's where we get into a problem, because you may or may not know that red lipstick colors, red shades, can be a red flag for lead. And I did buy some lead testing kits. They didn't come in time for me to test these products prior to making this video. But when I do get them, I will go back and test them, and I will let you know if any of these turn up to be positive for lead. The red DNC number 30, which is called Red Lake on the label, possibly has lead in it. Now, Jane Iredale is a very reputable company. They've been around for 25 years. Jane is a lovely woman. She's been a pioneer in the clean beauty industry. So I wouldn't think that they would put a product of concern. They've done a lot of work with cancer organizations, and I know that they are really out there to produce clean, safe cosmetics. So based on their reputation, I wouldn't think that this ingredient would be a problem, but like I said, it is a red flag. It is something to be concerned about. If you wanted to avoid that altogether, then all you need to do is purchase the sheer version instead of the shades, the tinted versions. So there is totally a workaround with that, and overall the ingredients in the product are fantastic. So number two is performance. Does this product do what it says it will do? On Jane Iredale's website, I'll just let you know what it says. Quench your lips with hydrating protection that will leave lips feeling moisturized, protected, and refreshingly scented. They call it mouth-watering moisture in a lip-saving balm. It has an SPF of 15. That is because of the titanium dioxide that is in it. It has 1.75%, I believe, which is just fine. It gives you a good SPF of 15. And then they say, a variety of waxes and oils combine to provide an antioxidant-rich protective shield. It has a refreshing lemon flavor. It's reef-safe, so no worries there. Free of octinoxate and oxybenzone. And it's recommended by the Skin Cancer Foundation as an effective broad-spectrum sunscreen. Does it do what it says it's going to do? Well, I've been wearing this around and I have not gotten sunburn on my lips at all, so it does feel like it's been quite protective. I do feel like it's very moisturizing. It is a little bit of a thicker lip balm, which is great. It feels very moist on. It is matte. It doesn't have any sheen to it, so that's nice too if you're looking for more of a matte lip balm. And the shades I have found to be really lovely. So as far as performance goes, I do feel like it works great. I haven't noticed any dryness at all when I've taken it off or after using it or wearing it. My lips do tend to be a little bit sensitive. I do notice when a lip balm is more drying. In fact, previously what I was using is just this lip balm from my orthodontist. And I needed a new one with an SPF in it, which is why I was searching and came across these Jane Iredale lip balms. This one has octinoxate in it, oxybenzone in it. If you have any SPF lip balms in your house, definitely check and see what the sunscreen is in it and make sure that it is one of the mineral sunscreens. So again, how is the performance? I think it performs great. I've had an excellent experience with it. It's very moisturizing and the SPF seems sufficient to protect my lips from the sun when I'm out walking, when I'm laying out, when I'm sitting in the sun. So performance-wise for me, gets a big check. It works great. Now, lastly, we have to look at sustainability and packaging. So this is a plastic package. It's not recyclable, it's not biodegradable, it's not refillable, so gets a little bit of a poor grade on that. Many of the products that I'm reviewing do. I would love to find some companies that are using innovative, sustainable packaging. If you know of any companies that are using innovative, sustainable packaging, please leave a comment below because I would love to try those products and review them for you here so that we can all be doing better for our planet and doing better for ourselves. So sustainability, not so much. But the product itself, a great, excellent grade for ingredients and an excellent grade for performance. Overall, I really like this product. I definitely recommend it. If you are looking for something like this, give it a try. This is a video about SPF and sun protection. I have done a couple of other videos lately about sunscreens for the face, for the body, mineral sunscreens, and why we need to get rid of chemical sunscreens. Go ahead and check those out if this is something you're interested in. If you're finding this information helpful, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you want more videos like this coming your way, and make sure to hit the little bell too so that you will get notified of our next episode. And I want to tell you that I'm going to begin doing 2 episodes per week starting next week. I will do a review video like this one, and I will also be bringing you more informational videos about sustainability, about natural living, about non-toxic ingredients, and how to live a clean, healthy, safe, and natural life. So I hope to see you here again next week. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you really enjoyed this information, and I'll look forward to seeing you next week. Thank you so much, everyone. I wish you the very best of health.